Okay, join with audio button option will be there. Please click on it. I'm keeping it here so that people who are not able to hear, you can see. Fine. Okay, chalo. So, welcome to Naresha Technologies, a great place for learning Java and Java technologies and any other software. So, if you are planning to come to software industry, you can proudly be a member of Okay, so quickly I'm revising what we discussed in last class. Last class we have just taken, you know, this welcome to Naresha IT, welcome to Java world, and welcome to programming, HK programming world. Okay, and then I talk about myself, okay, and then okay, our target learning in this session is knowing about me, about you, about this course, about Naresha IT, about your career, about projects, about courses, and finally about Java. So in last class I have completed about me and about you. Now today I want you understand, you know, about Naresha IT, about your, about this course, and about your career. Now we need to understand, okay, right. Now, okay, I ask you a few questions. I hope you all answered. I'm asking the same questions for the new students who joined today. So why you are here for learning Java? You all feeling that you are here for learning Java, but learning Java sufficient or not, we need to take decision. Why are you learning Java? For completing course, okay, or for getting job? Your target is for getting job, right? So for getting job, what will you do in company? You have to teach Java, or you will develop project. You will develop project. For developing project, what you must learn? Only Java, is it sufficient? No, you should learn Java and project development. Okay, what is our course must be? Okay, just learning Java is not sufficient. You must learn project development by using Java. Okay, fine. Then next, what is your target? Becoming a Java student? No, becoming software engineer is our target. So for by end of this course, you must become a software engineer for developing a project by using Java. And next, by end of this course, you must become an all-rounder. You must able to develop a project by using any language, using Java or Python or Go language. Okay, more detailed explanation I given in the previous video, you can go through once. Okay, so I don't want you become just Java learner to develop Java project. The specific mind I don't want you become. I want you become, you know, all rounder. That is what my target. So once you join in company, team lead, team manager asking you to develop project by using any language, you must able to develop. So by end of this course, you must become full stack developer. Full stack developer means you can develop. A full stack developer can develop a project by using any language in any part of the project. Okay, using any language, any part of the project, you must able to develop. Okay, what is your target in this course? Okay, in this course, your target is project development, learning project development. Okay, so this is what we have learned up to last class. Okay, so today I'm going to take you to the next. So we also still we learn, okay, about our course schedule. Course name is Core Java with Project Development. Type of training is full online, okay, till last session. Okay, we are not going to come for offline, only it is an online class. And next, duration is 60 to 70 sessions. Almost it takes 3 months. 3 months is minimum I'm talking. I'm not talking 3 months maximum, okay. 3 months minimum I'll take. Maybe it is extended to 1 or 2 months also. You must be ready for that. I want here give you full knowledge, not, you know, I'm not giving you full, I mean, I am here to give you full knowledge, not time passing, right? So 3 months minimum it will take, okay, maximum. It may take one more month also additional. If you're ready, then only take admission. So if you want to just come here, you know, putting some deadlines, if you want to complete, okay, then I cannot help you. Right, so better you take decision and then take admission. Okay, so daily class timing will be 2 hours, and the number of days per week will be 6 days per week, Monday to Saturday. Sometimes I'll take Sunday also. You must agree to come. Next, fee will be 2500, just 2500. Okay, prerequisites, no prerequisite, anyone can attend, who can join, anyone can join who wanted to learn Java from any branch. Okay, from any branch up to fifth class to postgraduate, anybody want to learn Java, they can join. Course material, I will provide soft copy via Google Drive, and assignments, I will give you daily assignments, and recorded videos, no recorded videos, every class is a live class, okay? Interview preparation, I will prepare you for interview. 1500 plus interview questions will be covered for you to pass interview, okay? No need to worry about your interview, it's my responsibility to make you pass interview. And next, new features, up to Java 16 version, I'm going to cover Java. Start from very beginning version, Java 1.0 to Java 16 version, everything I'm going to cover, no need to worry. And the syllabus I divided, start from 0 to 100% I want to teach. So first I will cover Java fundamentals, okay? If you want to write a simple basic hello world application, what the knowledge you need, and then to the complete high-end big project, okay, what knowledge you need, I will teach first. And then going to take object-oriented programming, then logical programming, then Java API and IDEs, and Java project development, okay? As part of Java API, you're learning a lot of things, collections, multi-threading. This is the big syllabus we are going to learn. 110 topics we are learning completely, okay? And then the most important architectures, why your seniors are forcing you to join in my class, because I am teaching Java with three architectures, MVC architectures, JVM architecture, and then what, LCRP architecture. By using these three architectures, you can be strong in a project designing and the program execution flow internals, and also LCRP architecture means project development architecture also will be very comfortable. In every chapter I'm going to cover, okay, interview questions, and then by end of the topic I'm going to cover, okay, project development. And in that particular chapter, what are the latest features we have, those features also I'm going to cover everywhere, okay? And then this is the way I'm going to cover core Java. I made Java learning simplified. You will not just learn Java, you will become software engineer, okay? And why you will become software engineer? Because I'm going to teach every topic, project-oriented training with real code snippets I'm going to teach. If I teach like this, then all I can guarantee you succeeded. If you succeeded, then I also succeeded, okay? So my next batch can be filled only if you get a job, right? Are you catching my point? I'm not college lecturer, okay? As a college lecturer, if I'm working, I will be aram se, can be relaxed, because it's management headache. And student anyways, they will come and join for their course, okay? For their admission purpose, they will come. But it is an institute. Institute means I have to take care of your success too. So your success is my success. So that I am preparing the Java syllabus and teaching Java very deep, right? Now Java 8 complete features, Java 9, Java 10, Java 12, Java 16 new features will be covered. Every topic will be talked with compiler and JVM internal algorithms. 1500 plus interview questions with Java SE 11. Developer certification bits will be covered. Chapter wise project based case study will be developed. You will experience the usage of every chapter in project development. By combining related chapters, mini projects will be developed. And by end of this course, you will think like a compiler and JVM to pass interview, and also to develop projects, you can also think like a project developer. That assurance I can give. And finally, I'm assuring that your first interview will be last interview. Is my voice is clear to all? Mukesh Kumar, maybe there is a problem your side, Nana. Okay, you need to increase your volume your side. Okay, from my side, there is no problem. No student have any problem. Okay, there is no chance to increase volume my side. Okay, I'm not using speakers, right? Are you catching my point? I'm not using speakers here, so there's no chance to increase volume my side. So please try to adjust your side, okay? So 100% volume is there. Okay, now? Okay, now let me try to. This is the topic we have completed up to last class. I given information about course and prerequisite and who can join this course, course duration, and about material and course syllabus and version. So this is what we completed up to last class. Okay. Again, I'm telling you, there is no prerequisites to learn Java. You can start Java as your first programming language. Okay, Bharadwaj, there are no prerequisites to learn Java from my class. You can start learning Java as your first programming language, no problem. Is it clear? In offline class, how can you clear your doubts, Bhiksha? When you get a doubt in the middle of the class, can you ask, or you will wait for last? Till end of the class, you will wait. Because in regular offline class, how can you clear your doubt? In the middle of the class, will you go and ask your lecturer when he is explaining? No, right? Then the same way. So hold your doubts, and when I ask you, do you have any questions? That time you post your questions, I will answer. Are you catching my point? I'm not running away anywhere. I am here to clear your doubts to make you understand, right? So hold your doubts. When I ask you, do you have any questions? Post your questions. Is it clear? Now moving to next. Rahi Shaikh, what is your question, Anna? I am explaining now. How can I take your questions? That is called common sense. When I am explaining, you should listen. Should not ask any questions, right? When I ask you, post your questions. You must post, right? So listen what I am telling first. Then when I give time to you to post your questions, I will read your questions and answer. Okay, fine. So try to habituate it, because this class is not one-to-one class. Okay, there are hundreds of students are there in the class. If all people are answering to questions, when I can complete what I need to explain, right? So when I give time to you, you can ask me. Fine. Now moving to the next point, right? So all you people listen first, and when I give time, you can put your questions in chat box. Now today I want to explain you something more about Naresheth. Okay, it's very very important. All you people should know what Naresheth is doing for you, why you should choose Naresheth for your institute learning any technology. Okay, how we are helping to get job quickly as a fresher and as a experience. So please try to listen carefully. Okay, don't feel that, you know, I am boosting Naresheth. These are the truth points I am trying to tell, so that you will know, your juniors come to know. And now Naresheth is the best training institute for learning any language or any technology. Okay, so you want to get a job in software industry by using one technology or one language, blindly you choose Naresheth, you will find the technology here and best faculty member who is working employee in company. Naresheth employees are not just, you know, trainers. They are not just trainers. They are working employees. They know how to use each language and each technology in the real-time company projects development. Then they are coming with their experience to teach you, to make you software engineer. So that's why Naresheth is sustaining as a number one institute last 16 years. Even COVID time also, we are finding good number of students. It's only because of the commitment we are giving to the student success. Right. So providing best classroom and online training, and classroom training or online training will be provided in normal track, fast track, weekend batches, one-to-one batches. Okay. Normal track, fast track means, okay, if you are time limit, okay, in 40 days, I want to complete, then choose a fast track. time is not a problem, I want you know, full knowledge, then choose normal track. So my classes are normal track, means my target is giving you subject. I'm giving you time, but it may take more time also. You should be ready, because my target is giving you full knowledge. Until full topic completed, I will not leave you, even you are crying also. Okay, so that is what commitment you have to give it to me. And the next, come to the next point, you know, what are the courses we are giving to you is also you should know. Now CRT, C, C++, data structures, Java, .NET, PHP, Python, and Go language. Okay, the, I mean, Go language is not yet started. Okay, in future we will also continue Go language also. Already syllabus and everything is ready. Once the boom started, we will going to launch the course. So CRT means campus recruitment training, nothing but aptitude, arithmetic and reasoning. Okay, arithmetic and reasoning is nothing but CRT. So in arithmetic and reasoning is the most important, every fresher has to learn to get a job. So the first interview, in the interview, first exam will be, first test will be conducted on CRT. And then now we are moving to the particular language. Okay, if you are applying job for Java, CRT next Java. If you're applying for .NET, CRT next .NET, CRT PHP, CRT Python, like that will be there. These are the languages. And then back behind languages, back end of languages, databases will be there. Every language using its own database. Java people, Oracle will use. .NET, SQL Server, PHP, Python, will use MySQL and MongoDB. Okay, so these are the databases also offering by Naresh IT. And then front end, okay, languages middle will be there, back end database, front end we have programming languages, UI technologies, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Angular, React, Node, MongoDB, Express.js, UV.js, right? So though so many JavaScript frameworks are came, front end also will be there. So front end technologies also we are teaching you, so that you will become full stack developer, okay? So if you want to develop one project, whatever the courses required, everything we are offering. And then now some people wanted to go for developing Android application. So Android and iOS also we are offering. And then next, some people want to go for a testing side, Selenium and RPA, robotic processing automation. So these courses also we are providing. Which platform you want, for every platform we have courses. And then some people want cloud computing, okay? They want AWS, Azure, DevOps, Salesforce, they want. So these courses also we have. And then some people want to go for data science side. Okay, people who learn Python, they have to go to data science platform. So Python, combination data science, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, Hadoop, okay? So this side also you can go by learning Python. For that also we are providing courses with real-time working employees. And then finally, any course you do on back-end, any course you do back-end, the operating system will be used for deploying our projects will be Unix or Linux. So Unix and Linux operating system course also we are providing. So these are the minimum courses there in the market to get the job. Any of these courses you can choose. So if you choose Java or Python language, then you have to learn database and HTML front-end also. If you want to learn Android also, Android plus HTML Oracle. Okay, there is a SQLite. Android people has to learn SQLite. So any course you take, front end, back end, middleware. Okay, all the three parts you have to learn to become full stack developer. Then tell me these courses to teach the faculty members. Okay, we are on these courses, just doing courses are not sufficient. You need to do projects also. Then some students required to submit their projects in final year, right? Finally, you have to submit one project to your college. Okay, finally, final semester will be there. So for that purpose, we are also providing you academic project on all above courses. Okay, Naresh IT is not only contains a teaching department, okay, training department, we're also having development department, projects development also we have. And then we have high experienced best faculty members for both projects department and also courses department, okay? So for training all these courses and for developing the projects, we have best faculty member who are working in industry. So because we are providing this much, depth knowledge, we have the students across the globe. That means, you take any company, in every company, minimum 5% of the employees of that company will be from Naresh IT, no doubt in that, okay? So when you join in company, slowly you'll come to know, hey, you are also Naresh IT, I'm also Naresh IT, you also HK product, I'm also HK product. So slowly, slowly we'll realize by the way you are talking in the subject, you can easily catch they're from Naresh IT or not, okay? Right, so tell me, we have the students across the globe, then tell me, based on the students' performance in that company wish to recruit more students from a Naresh IT, na? Right. Based on that record, we are providing placement at free of cost. No need to pay single rupee, just at the course cost. At the just course cost, we are providing you placement also. Okay. And maximum companies are offering 3 to 4 lakh per annum. Few companies are also coming with 2 to 3 lakh per annum. Now, this month, we are conducting one exam called screening test exam. So people who qualified in that screening test, they are going to place in the placement batch. So through that placement batch, all the students are going to send to the companies, right? So tell me, we have 3 departments are there. Number one, training department, development department, and placement department. All 3 department employees are very strong in their departments. Okay. If you're looking for training cum placement, Naresh IIT is the best choice without any second thought. Okay. Right. So Naresh IIT promising 100% placement. Why conditions apply? You know, star means what? Conditions apply. Naresh IIT providing 100% placement for whom? For the students who are serious about their career. Okay, you also should promise to us. Okay, people who are giving promise that passing screening test. If you pass a screening test, okay, 100% placement is our responsibility. Are you ready for that? Come on. Are you ready for that? Are you ready to pass screening test exam? Sir, screening test exam is a tougher, easier. That's a damn easy exam. Okay, screening test exam is a damn easy exam. You can easily qualify. Whatever the questions, whatever the subject I am covering, those points only will come in the screen text exam. Are you able to hear me? Your chat window working? No one is responding. Are you there? Yeah, look at here. So this is free 100% job guaranteed program only for Naresh IIT students. Okay, package 2 to 6 lakh per annum. Okay, 9th April is the exam conducting. People who are belongs to Java, Stream, Python, .NET, Selenium, UI. Okay, and the people who are coming from BE, BTech, MCA, 18, 19, 20, 20 passed outs. These students are eligible to apply for this exam. Okay, people who are coming from BSc background, BCom background, or BCA background, my suggestion, try to also do MCA, either regular or distinction. So MCA is important for getting jobs. Many companies are asking job, providing job only for BE, BTech, MCA students only. So if you are this year passed out or BSc or BCA, try to plan for doing MCA also. Okay, it's my recommendation. Okay. So this is the story about Naresh IIT. And then if you want to follow Naresh IIT Technologies for new courses, okay, and other things, if you want to follow, you can follow the website NareshIIT.com. If you want to find a new jobs, okay, NareshIIT.com. I'll show you. How to find new batch details, because you need to do a lot of courses. Yeah, virtual placement assurance on Java, .NET, Python, UI technologies, Selenium. Selection process, online screening test, virtual technical discussion, shortlisted trainees to attend placements drives. Okay, 30 companies placements in the next coming 25 days. This is our commitment. Okay, now once you come to this NareshIIT.com, click on new batches. Don't click, just move your mouse on the new batches and see here Hyderabad, click on Hyderabad. Okay, scroll down. You'll find all the new batches here. Full stack Java developer new batch, data science and AI, UI full stack web development, Salesforce CRM, ASP.NET, DevOps, data science, HTML, JavaScript, CSS. Okay, at 11 a.m. HTML, JavaScript, CSS, you have to join at 11 a.m. Okay, start from today itself, starting today, go on register. It's important batch for you. You have to join this batch. I'm sharing these links. All the people try to do registration. I'll tell you why you need to join this HTML course. And then also you should join Oracle. Okay, let's see any other Angular, Android, Django, Core Java, Python. Oracle by Sudhakar L sir. Okay, what is the timing? Oracle. Yeah, it's a 7:30 a.m. Yeah, so wonderful batch here. So you got super. You got parallel batches. All you students has to learn 3 courses at a time. Core Java. Oh, this is HTML. 1 second here. I send same thing. Yeah. HTML. Core Java, Oracle, HTML. Okay. Core Java, HTML, Oracle. These 3 courses you have to start at a time. Are you catching my point? You have to start all these 3 courses at a time. So then you will be in a track of learning all the courses. Okay, right. So Sudhakar L sir and Shivakumar sir, HTML faculty Shivakumar sir, having plenty of experience, having good knowledge of these courses, you will definitely enjoy the discussion. Okay, so happily you can go and join and start learning them. 3 courses you have to start at a time. Okay, this is our Naresh IT website, you have to follow. And also if you want, you know, Facebook like and follow, you can also follow Facebook. Right. And then next, seshajobs.com. There are so many companies which are recruiting outside of Naresh IT. We don't want to leave them also. So we are also posting those jobs in this website. You can follow. And this is a Facebook page. And also you need to follow youtube.com/Naresh IT. Okay. Just to go to YouTube and type Naresh IT. Okay. You will get our channel and you can follow our videos. So every day, new things. Okay. New technologies based videos we are uploading. You definitely enjoy them. Okay, then now this is the story about Naresh IT websites. And now you got some problem. Okay, you joining time some problem there, payment time some problem there. So whom you can contact? Okay, our class have our own specific assigned admin is there. His name is Mr. Nagbabu. Okay, so just you contact him and this is the number. All you people note down, save in your mobile. Don't call him at any time. Okay, don't call, he will not leave the phone. It is only work for WhatsApp messages only. Okay, all you people note down. Okay. And now I have completed. I given full information about Naresh IT. Okay, I have shared information about training, placement, and projects department, and faculty's experience and training procedure. Okay, and different courses and academic projects, and Naresh IT students caliber, and placements track record, Naresh IT promise and ever promise. Okay, and websites and YouTube channel details and our class admin details. Any questions? Yeah, Rahil, I will teach you compiler functionality also. How compiler work, how JVM work also I will teach. Okay, shall I continue the next points? Can you please confirm today you are all very, very dull? Why? Not responding, got angry? The chat window working for all people? Okay. So shall I go to the next point? Up to now, any doubts? Okay. So tell me once again, what is our target? Come on, come on. Now the next 1 hour is very important. Expecting all you people to interact with me. Come forward, come forward. Yesterday you are very much interactive. Today you are very dull. I don't know why. What happened? Why you are very silent? Why are you very silent? Come on, come on. What is our target? Becoming software engineer to develop project by using Java, right? So our target is becoming project. Okay, we must able to develop project by using any programming language, Java, Python, or Go language. This is our target. Okay, fine. Then now I want to ask you a question. Think and tell me. If you wanted to develop a project, first of all, you should know what is the architecture of the project. Come on, say yes or no. Come on, interact. We should know what is the architecture of the project and why we are developing project and what are the different courses we need to do to develop project, right? So now next coming 1 hour is most important for you. Skills required to develop a project. So what we are trying to learn, skills are required to develop a project. My target is developing project. Okay, to develop project, what are the skills required? Okay, tell me, you take any website here, any website you take. Project is nothing but, can I say website? Come on, yes or no? Come on, interact. I want to take any website. A website is a project. Tell me one good website, what you follow daily. So that I can choose that one to explain. Tell me one website. Choice is yours. Come on, come on. Don't say tutorial website here, some business website. Don't say tutorial website, some business website. Business, some business website. Okay. Naukri.com, Flipkart.com, Amazon.com. Okay. So shall I take Flipkart? Okay, I'm taking Flipkart.com. Tell me, this is Flipkart.com. Whenever I press, I got so much of information on the browser. This information is available in my system, in my computer. Just to say yes or no, right? Come on, interact. If you interact, then you will get an idea. If you are not interacting, sit silently. Next coming 1 hour, very tough. Next coming 1 hour is life-changing session. Okay, again telling, next coming 1 hour is life-changing session. Please try to interact. Wake up, sit down properly. Wake up, people who are lay down on the bed and listening class, get up, sit down properly. This 1 hour, 1 hour will change your life. Just sit down properly and try. All people try to type. Now tell me, whatever information is showing in this browser, on this browser, what are the information showing on this browser? Is this information is a part of my computer? Is it there in my computer? No, right? It's not there in my computer. It's everything is downloading from Flipkart server, right? Now, if you assume the diagram something like this, if you assume the project diagram something like this, this is the project. Okay, I'm taking this is server computer. Which is server computer? Okay, Flipkart. Flipkart server computer. In a Flipkart server computer, we have information. But I have a question. All this data, whatever you are seeing, is it available? Is this available in the Flipkart computer? No. It is available in a concept called what? Database. Okay, it is available in a concept called what? Database. So observe now, we have a concept called database. Database is represented like this, buddy. Next coming 1 hour is very important. It is your life changing session. Please don't sleep. 4 o'clock is generally sleep time. It's a 5 almost. Wake up. Now this is database. Okay, this is a database. Then tell me, in database we have table. Okay, database contains data in terms of a table. In table only we have column. Okay, several columns will be there. Now here we have, this is a, I can say, product table. Okay, I would like to call it as a product table. In product table, now we have all the columns, whatever. Then now here at this side, somewhere in the world, okay, one client is there happily. He's taken his chair, okay, and sit on the chair, and he wanted to browse. Then what he will do, he will open his computer. Tell me, can I say this computer is client computer? The person who is accessing our project is called client, and the client on the person computer is called what? Client computer. Okay, client computer and server computer. Tell me, this client computer and server computer connected through network, na? So this is called network, internet connection here. This is network, internet connection. So now it is pointing. Okay, it is connected. Okay, and then what this person will do, he will open browser. Like how I have open browser, he is also opening browser, and he typed flipkart.com. Come on, everyone should answer. The moment I type flipkart.com, then what happened? Now something is, it will via in network, it is going to Flipkart server. From there, something is downloaded into our computer and displaying. Yes or no? That means here there is some information. Okay, what is that information? That is what, as a developer, you have to develop. All are catching my point? So this end user, I'm writing here, E-U is nothing but end user. This end user requires some data. The data is available in the database. Now I need some programs here. Now I'm using some technical words. I need some programs here, pull the data from the database and show to the end user. And end user given data, collect it and store in the database. This is the target. Yes or no? Now all you people try to apply your mind now. Go to flipkart.com now, apply your thoughts here. Tell me, if you want to browse any information here, first I have to log in, right? Okay. First, I have to log in. Click on login. If you want to log in, first I should have account. So click on sign up. Then I am giving here, enter mobile number. Okay. And then continue. If I give all the information, then tell me my account details are going on storing in the database, right? All the people can answer. It is going on storing in the database. So for that, I need one program, right? That's what I'm trying to explain now, this 1 hour. All are ready? All are interested to learn? What is happening background? To collect the information from this browser, there should be a program. This program is called UI program. Okay, this program is called UI program. This program will go to browser, from the user, end user, collect the information and send to the database, and collect the database data from the database and display data on browser to end user. But this UI program is responsible for only collecting information from end user, that's all. Okay, and display the data to the end user. Are you catching my point? Right, it cannot interact to the database, because the data available in database, I need one more program to interact to the database. Okay, that program is technically called, okay, now database interaction application, or database interaction program, DI program. Okay, database interaction program. I'm not going to give you many big terminology, simple terminology for you to understand. I'm using it. So the program which is interacting with end user is called UI program. okay, UI program. So it is responsible for interacting with the end user to collect the inputs and display output. Next, I need one more program interact with the database. That program name is what? Database interaction program, which is responsible for storing data in database, reading data from database. But now the question, before storing data in a database, before reading data from database, I need some program to do some calculations now, right? For example, now I'm giving you here, I'm selecting one product here, okay? I'm selecting one product here, okay? I wanted to buy some, okay, electronics, I want to buy, click on it. Okay, now I'm clicking on this. Now I want to buy this one. So when I click on it, okay, some calculations has to be done, okay? You open this. Now here you can see 1,199 rupees. Actual price is 3,499 rupees. It has to do some calculations here. So after these calculations, now the final result should be displayed. So now in the middle of the project, I need some calculations to do. That calculation program is this, okay? Calculator. This calculation program is called actually business logic, B logic program. Okay, this calculation doing program is called business logic or B logic program. So tell me, a project, if you take a project is divided into how many programs? Simple, three programs. Number one, UI program. Number two, business logic program. Number three, database interaction program. Can I hope all you people understand first of all these points? Could you able to accept these points up to now? Then I have a question, tell me. Then what is the flow of execution? All the people try to answer. End user, click on flipkart.com. Then because of flipkart.com, it will go to through the network. It will go to Flipkart server. And one of the UI programming is downloaded here. That's what you are seeing. Okay, whatever you are seeing, that is a program. After downloading it, then what happened next? Here some application from front end screen, you are seeing buttons and images and everything. Then somewhere you clicked it. Then when you click on it, then again through the network, it is going to where business logic program. From there, it is going to database interaction program. From there, it is collecting some information from the database, whichever the products I am asking, that give it to the business logic program, that is giving to UI program. Then UI program displaying that next screen to us. Can you apply this point in this diagram? Can you apply that program here? Please apply all the people once again. Very important. For example, I wanted to go back. Okay, I am going close this one. I go back to some other product. Okay, let's say I want to buy the Samsung mobile. Click on it. Okay, then when I click on it, what happened? Tell me. The moment I click, this page is coming how? Come on. This page is coming where? When I click on that button, it is going to server. Server to business logic to database interaction. From there to database. From the database, this entire information is collected and displaying to us. So tell me, up to now, you are the user. As a user, always what are you doing? Just you clicking on whatever you are seeing the buttons here. Okay, whatever you are seeing, just you are clicking on them, right? Just you are clicking on them and getting data or not you are seeing. But now, you want to become a user or you want to become developer? You want to become developer. Okay, if you want to become developer, you should know how to develop that project. What are the courses I need to do to develop this project? You required that idea, na? So that is the target of this session. Are you ready? If you say ready, I will introduce. Otherwise, I will go to next. Because your interest is most important than what I am teaching. All are you ready to? Are you interested to learn? Tell me now. So you are telling yes. UI program you want to develop. To develop UI program, what are the courses you require? Tell me. You need a HTML course. Okay. You need HTML course. You need CSS. You need JavaScript. Okay, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript you have to learn. If you don't learn HTML, CSS, JavaScript, can you provide a face to your project? Can you provide a front end screen to your project? Can end user access your project? Is it possible or not possible? not possible. So tell me, if you don't learn this course, can you develop, can you get job, can you work in the company? Not possible. Okay, next. Now I want to develop database interaction program. Okay, to develop database interaction program, I can say in place of database interaction program, okay, I'll come there. Okay, to develop business logic program, I need what? Logic to develop. One programming language is required. Okay, one programming language. Okay, that business logic program to develop, DI program to develop, I need one programming language. Now the question, the programming language you have chosen what? Java. Now in Java, which part is comes under programming? Core Java. You should learn core Java. All are catching my point? Then, so what are the courses you have to learn to develop a project? Skills required to develop a project. That's what our target. So to develop project, you have to perform three activities. To perform these three activities, I need to learn. These are the courses. Okay, first of all, if you want to interact with the database, I need to learn database also. So let me give you a conclusion. Here, look at there. Business logic is nothing but performing some calculations, performing some validations, performing some calculations. Please look at here. Please look at here. I wanted to ask you one small question. Look at here. Go back to the Flipkart. Look at there. This is the price. Actual price is 2,295 rupees. Now, on this price, they are giving 15% off. Then this is the final result amount you have to pay. Tell me, if you wanted to find what is the 15% percentages calculation, you should know, na? Come on, come on. So tell me what you must learn first. If you want to develop this Flipkart project, first you should not learn how to develop project. Okay, you should not learn HTML file and all. First you should learn problem solving skills. Okay, what are the programming skills you require? Problem solving skills you have to learn first. Okay, if I give one problem to you, what is the formula you should apply? What is the procedure you should follow to solve a problem? Again, repeating, what is the formula? What is the procedure? Algorithm, we call algorithm. So in problem solving skills, you should learn how to solve a problem, the procedure, algorithm, and formula you have to learn. Are you catching my point? Then this problem solving skills you will get in a course called CRT. What the course name would be? What the course name? CRT. You have to learn CRT. Okay, then next. Now you learn how to develop, okay, how to solve a problem, you learn, okay? Then that problem you want to solve manually or programmatically? Programmatically, by computer. Okay, I want to write a program. I will give one number, find the percent, 15% of that number, return the result. This calculation I don't want to do manually. This calculation I want to do programmatically. For that, I need to develop one program. So converting this manual procedure and calculation formula as a program is nothing but we call what logical programming skills. Okay, maybe you are from the non-IT IT background, you know, right? Data types, operators, control flow statements, conditions, loops, switch blocks, operators. So the program you are writing around data types, operators, control flow statements is nothing but what? Logical programming skills. Are you catching my point? Then problem solving skills and logical programming skills. I have a question now. All you people answer. Now you are doing this calculation just for one number like in mathematics? No. You are performing this calculation for one object. This is an object. This is a business. I am doing the sales. Okay. I am performing this operation for one object, for one business I am doing. If you are doing this calculation for one object, for one business, then we call it as object-oriented programming. Am I going fast? All are you understanding? So what are the skills you require to develop this? What the skills you require to develop this business logic program? Okay, to develop this business logic program, you must acquire three skills. What are the three skills you require? Problem solving skills, logical programming skills, object oriented programming skills. Tell me, in problem solving skills, what are you learning? Procedure to solve a problem and required formulas. Okay, next. Now logical programming skills. Now tell me, in logical programming skills, what are you learning? You are learning logical programming skills. You are learning how to convert that procedure and formula as a program. Let me give you an idea. Okay, simple idea I want to give you. Now I'm asking, okay, I'll find the percentage of given number. What is the procedure you'll follow? take one number. Second, take a percentage. Okay, next, third, how to calculate percentage of given number? Multiply that number with given percentage number and divide result by 100. Okay, this is the procedure. Okay, this is the procedure. Tell me now, this procedure, what formula it required? Number into percentage by 100. So this is the manual procedure. Are you catching my point? So this is the algorithm and this is the manual procedure you are following. Now this manual procedure, I should convert it as what program? What is that program? Logical programming. Okay, logical programming means simply you write like this. First, I should take one number, na? I am writing here double number equal to something, let's say 2000 rupees, I am writing. Next, take percentage, double percentage equal to let's say 20%. Okay, and next, multiply given number with given percentage and store the result. Double result equal to number plus, I want to find, okay, final result, na? Okay, number plus, okay, I want to find, okay, number minus, na? I should deduct, right? I want to deduct final amount, means I should deduct, na? Number minus, what do you write? Number into percentage divided by 100, semicolon. So converting this procedure, try to understand, converting this procedure into a program like this, if you write, this is called logical programming. So people who are coming from non-IT background, try to focus what I am talking. So this is called algorithm, okay, and this is a formula. Okay, now this algorithm and formula, if you are following, is a manual task you are doing. Now that manual task I converted as a program. What program it is? Logical programming skills, right? But I don't want to do logical programming, means I don't want just for number. This 2000 is the product number, right? So I have to convert it as a object oriented programming. For that, you have to write program something like this, class product. Okay, sir, I'm not understanding what is this class. I'm not explaining what is class. I'm telling what is the meaning of object-oriented program. If you write this formula inside a class with the name product, inside something like this void, find percentage, okay? Or, find total cost, okay? Find total cost or whatever. Find total cost, whatever. Open bracket, closed bracket. Okay, if you write like this, if you arrange this formula procedure inside program like this, then we call it as what? Object-oriented programming. So inside a Flipkart website, okay, all these are done background. You cannot see whatever you are seeing here, this everything background done by Flipkart company. Erabuji, all people understand? So whatever you are doing here in our course, that already done by whom? This is done by Flipkart. So whatever the Flipkart done, that you are learning now as part of our course. Did you get clarity what I'm talking? Up to now, all people comfortable? Okay, if you want to develop a project, what are the skills required? Number one, problem solving skills. Number two, logical programming skills. Number three, object-oriented programming skills. All these three skills, if you acquire, then only you can develop a program to perform one operation in a project. Any of these skills, if you don't acquire, then you cannot write a basic program. You cannot be a programmer. Forget about the project. Simple basic programs also you cannot develop. So am I able to make you understand clearly what you need to do? All people got clarity? I'll take one more website. You have to tell me all these things there. Okay. Now tell me now. If you just learn object-oriented programming up to this, okay, is it sufficient? No, no. I have to store this final payment in the database, right? Because this entire information is coming from where? Database. This 2,295 rupees is coming from where? Database. So tell me, if you wanted to, store data in database, read from database, I need to learn database programming. By using object-oriented programming, I generate the results. Those results I stored inside database. Further, I need to read that result and store to the end user. For that, I need what? This is screen. This is screen is called what? UI programming skills. Okay, if you learn these five skills, then you are called a programmer. You are called a project developer. You can develop project. Are you ready to draw project once again? This is my project. Come on, everyone should answer now. Okay, this is my project. Please, Nana. Please, Nana. Very, very important. We come to the conclusion, right? In this project, now we are having database to store data. Everyone should answer, please. So for storing data in a database, we need to learn database programming skills. Now the database programming skills is nothing but Oracle. Okay, courses we'll see later. Don't worry. First, I want to write database. Then next, under project, now I need to develop one program. I need to develop one program. What? UI program I required. And then next, I need one more program to do calculations. I need one more program to do calculations. Okay, calculation program. Okay, then next, I have a question. All you people try to think. UI program is available in server computer. Listen, listen, listen. Very important point. Final conclusion. Last point. Please try to notice. This is a browser. From the browser, I requested this UI program. It is downloaded and coming here. Here I have the browser HTML program came or some image came. I click on this image. Listen, sir, my statement very important. Now this image related information available in the database. Then it is going to server side to this calculation program. Na? Sorry, it cannot go. Listen, listen, listen. It cannot go. This calculation program cannot access from the browser from the internet. Again, repeating, this calculation program cannot access from the browser, from the internet. It is not possible to access. Rabuji, all you people catch my point. It is not possible to access from the browser. Then what we need? For example, you are going to Japan. Can you talk to Japanese people now? Can you talk? Is it possible? No, you don't know Japanese language, you don't know. So you need one translator who can convert your language to Japanese language. That translator I need here. Okay, we need one program here who can connect, who can take the values from the browser, who can take the values from the browser and give that values to the calculator program. Are you catching my point? Calculator program cannot take the value directly from the network. We need some program. This mediator program is technically called server side program. What we call server side program. Tell me what is the other skill we required? Server side programming. So this is server side program is responsible for collecting the data from the browser and giving the data to calculator program. By taking that value, it will start doing all the calculation here. Then after calculation, result is generated. Na? This result must go and store in the database. Oh, hello. This calculator program cannot interact with the database. We need one more program here for interacting with the database. Are you catching my point? Right. So we need one more program here. That is what? Database interaction program we require. Now it is giving to here. This fellow will go and store in the database. So totally, how many skills you require to develop a project? Number one, problem solving skills for knowing algorithm and formula. Logical programming skills to convert that manual calculation to a program. Object-oriented programming skills to perform that mathematical calculation for one object. And next, one object as part of business. Database programming. database programming to prepare these database tables and all. And next, UI programming skills to present data to the end user, to collect data from end user. Server side programming for interacting with the network to collect the data from browser to give the calculator program. Okay, na? So this is the basic important idea you required. And next, tell me very important point. You know, I want fast development. Okay, the project I want to develop fast. Okay, if you take these things for you know, develop the project, it may take 1 year to develop. Okay, can I wait for 1 year to develop my project? No, I cannot. I want fast development. Quickly, I want to complete project development. For fast development, we need one more thing, that is called frameworks. Okay, so tell me, if you want to develop a project totally, how many skills you require to acquire? Any programming language you take, Java you take, .NET you take, Python you take, PHP you take, any programming language you take, these are the 7 skills you need to acquire. Erabuji, all the people are comfortable? These are the 7 skills you need to acquire. Any programming language you take, these are the compulsory. I'm not talking with any language. I'm talking about project. You want to develop a project by using one language, these are the 7 skills you require. Then, now what are the courses I have to do? Because you choose Java, as part of Java, what are the courses you need to do? I'm highlighting. Problem solving skills you need to go for, CRT. Logical programming skills, C and data structure. Object-oriented programming, core Java. Database programming, Oracle, SQL, PLSQL, UI programming skills, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, server-side programming, advanced Java, JDBC, Servlet, and JSP. JDBC for database interaction, Servlet and JSP for network interaction. Okay, next, fast development purpose, we need to learn frameworks, tools, and design patterns. All are catching my point? So what are the courses you need to do? These are the courses you have to do. So if you want to become a project developer, if you want to develop a project, these are the courses you have to do. Yesterday, some people has asked me, sir, is just core Java sufficient to learn to get a job? Now you take the decision, just by learning core Java, will you get a job? Come on. Just by learning core Java, will you get a job? You are the best fielder in the world. Okay. You are the best fielder in the world. Will you get place in cricket team? You don't know how to batting. You don't know how to bowling. You know only fielding. Only fielding, okay? Then will you get a place in a team? No, right? Core Java, if you learn, you'll become just a fielder. So if you want to become, if you want to place, you should be either specialist batsman or specialist bowler or all-rounder. Right? You want to say, just I will field it and you will not give the space. So just learning core Java, you will not get a job. All are catching my point? Just by learning core Java, you will not get a job. You must also learn CRT. If you want to pass as a fresher, if you want to pass interview, you must learn CRT. Okay. And next, you should have a knowledge on writing programs, C and data structure. And that C and data structure programs you have to convert as a object oriented programming core Java. Now to store the data in database Oracle, HTML, JavaScript, CSS, advanced Java, these all you have to learn. Okay, so tell me now, project architecture to show usage of all above courses, where the courses must be learned, freshers and experience. Okay, I wanted to continue. Right, let me open another PPT. I will give you conclusion on this. Give me 1 minute. Right, so what are the courses you have to do? Problem solving skills, CRT, logical programming skills, C and VS, object oriented programming, core Java, database programming skills, Oracle, UI programming, HTML, and then server side programming, fast development. Okay, now what are the courses you must learn? CRT, C and DS, core Java, Oracle, HTML, JavaScript, advanced Java, frameworks. What are the frameworks? Hibernate, Spring, Angular, or React. Okay, right. For JavaScript fast development, Angular or React you have to learn. For advanced Java framework, Java frameworks are Hibernate and Spring. Look at there, the red color marks are Java related. Remaining are common to all languages. And then you should learn XML web services. XML web services. XML web services also called RESTful services or REST API. Okay. And Java tools you have to learn. Nothing but nowadays people are calling it as a DevOps. And also you should learn design patterns. Finally, one project development knowledge. These are the totally 11 courses you have to do. Then as a fresher, how many courses you need to learn to get a job? As a fresher, these 6 courses are mandatory. You want to enter it into company to develop a project, these 6 courses are compulsory. After completing these 6 courses only, you are eligible to enter into company for interview. Until you not completed these 6 courses, you are not even not eligible to apply for interview also. Sir, now I am a fresher. Should I learn frameworks and XML web services, these things also? No? It is essential. Just now I told you, companies are looking for fast development. No? For fast development, they are using frameworks. Okay, I will explain you project one more time with all these courses one more time. Okay, just you try to concentrate on what I'm trying to tell. Okay, frameworks are using for developing projects fast. So CRT compulsory, CDS Core Java, these 3 are compulsory, Oracle compulsory. Now HTML JavaScript players, people are now using Angular or React. And advanced Java players, people are using Hibernate and Spring for fast development. Okay, na? Everyone understand? Then tell me, if companies are using frameworks, if you don't learn, you will face problem, na? That's why my recommendation is, after completing these 6 courses, now you try for the job, go for interviews. While attending interviews, also continue your course of learning, frameworks, XML web service, Java tools, design patterns, all also you learn. Is it clear? Then, can I give you the order of before going there, sir, I am an experienced person. What courses I need to do? As a fresher, these are the courses I am doing, sir. It's okay. And now I am an experienced person. As an experienced person, what are the courses I need to do? Look at here. As an experienced person, you have to do all courses. There is no other option. Okay, I am trying job with 3+ years of experience or 4+ years of experience I am trying. Then which course I have to do? All courses you have to do. So CRT also compulsory. Yeah? If you learn CRT, you will be strong in problem solving skills. Okay? You will be good in problem solving skills. Right. So now, in which order I have to learn these courses? Java course completion steps I'm going to give you. Try to watch. In which order I have to do that? Now first you have to start Core Java, Oracle, HTML. All 3 courses you have to do at a time. Already I shared you, the new batches already started for you. 4 o'clock Core Java, 11 o'clock HTML, morning 7:30 a.m. Oracle. 7:30 a.m. or 7:30 p.m. check once. Okay, go to Naresh Shetty website. These 3 courses minimum you have to do. Yes or no? Go back to the project once again. Now in project, if you want to develop a project, what I required? This is my project. In my project, what I required? Okay, first UI technologies, and then programming, and then database. So these 3 you have to learn first. While learning these 3, you are going keep on continue learning. Now tell me, while learning this, if you want to make it as a project, come on, you need to interact HTML program to Core Java program. So this is HTML program. This is HTML program. And this is Core Java program. So now this HTML program to Core Java program to connect, I need one middle program. That middle program is what? Servlet and JSP. The middle program is Servlet and JSP. That Servlet and JSP program comes under advanced Java. Now this Core Java program want interact with what? A database. It cannot directly interact. For that we need one mediator program. That mediator program is what? JDBC. All are you accepting my words? Try to accept, Nana. Don't understand. Try to accept. So end user is interacting with HTML. HTML interacting with the servlet. Servlet interacting with the Core Java. Core Java interacting with the JDBC. JDBC interacting with the database. This is the process. So tell me, if you wanted to learn HTML, Core Java, and database, there are no prerequisites. That's why all 3 courses you have to start at a time. If you want to learn servlet and JDBC, there is a prerequisite, right? Tell me, Servlet is meant for connecting HTML to Core Java. So without knowing HTML and Core Java, can you join advanced Java? No. and tell me, JDBC is meant for connecting core Java and database. Without knowing core Java and database, can you start JDBC? Not possible. So yesterday some students has asked me question, sir, can I join advanced Java parallel to core Java at a time? Not possible. In the middle of core Java, after object oriented programming completed, then you can go either CDSCRT, or you can go with what, advanced Java. Without completing core Java object oriented programming, SQL and HTML, you are not eligible to attend advanced Java. Okay na? So as a freshers, you have to follow, this is the process of learning courses you have to follow: core Java, Oracle, HTML, after object oriented programming completed, CNDSCRT or advanced Java you can join. Then now, after one of the courses completed, any one of the course, after 30-40 days, one of the course will be completed. In that slot, now you plan for Hibernate frameworks, and then you plan for Spring Boot you can plan, okay, and then XML web services you can plan, and finally Java real time project you can plan. So this is the courses order you have to follow. I will give you detailed notes and everything, don't worry. Okay, detailed notes I will give you, don't worry. At this minute, just I am trying to give you the order of doing the courses. Okay, detailed notes and everything I will provide you, don't worry. So can I expect all you people got some idea what are the courses you need to do to become a project developer, in which order you have to do? And now, totally how many months you are going to take to complete this entire course? If you follow the order I have given to you, okay, if you follow the order I have given to you, then you will take 7 to 8 months to complete this all courses. Okay, 7 to 8 months minimum you have to spend to complete all these courses. Do you have that much time? Again, I'm repeating, as a fresher, you don't wait to attend interviews till all courses completed. Once you finish up to advanced Java, you have to start attending interviews. Okay, and then you continue learning frameworks also. Experienced people, you have to wait till full course completed. Until real-time project completed, you have to wait. After complete real-time project completed, then you can go for attending interviews and get job. As a fresher, prerequisite knowledge is up to advanced Java, you have to wait. Okay. And now, this is what I wanted to share in today's class. So tell me now you people come up with your questions, I'm ready to answer. So if you have any still questions, if I feel that I didn't answer some of your questions, now you can ask. No, not SQL Server, Oracle course. SQL Server for .NET students, not for Java students. And Rahil, I will tell you when to take payment and all, don't worry. I will give you admission process, I will give you how to do the payment and all. As of now, no need to worry about any payment. Just you try to understand what I'm telling. Any other questions, buddy? Is chatting is working today? Why people are very silent? I don't understand. Chat window working or not? Vaibhav, already told you, all three courses you have to join parallel. Again, why you are asking, can I join Oracle now? I ask you to join, right? Yeah, Spring Boot you can join after Hibernate. That's why given, after advanced Java or while doing Hibernate. There is no rule. I give an arrow mark from advanced Java. only core java no job up to advanced java you have to learn ना बाबू sorry guys okay mic mute is there on mute I didn't observe I am answering all your questions shit okay by muting I am answering all your questions okay let me answer to your questions again people who are working who want to go to selenium side learn only core java don't learn complete course okay na people who wanted to do complete core java side job then only do all these things okay is clear my point and each course fee details I don't know you have to talk to administrator fee details talk to administrator okay yeah prayas I answered to your question only prayas okay for going to software testing side don't join all courses only core java anuk you want a job as an experienced person na? To get job as an experienced person you have to do all these courses you want java side experienced person means you have to join all these courses and data structures algorithm is added advantage yeah full stack course will include oracle html other courses also please go and check our website only for core java 3 months it will take oracle I am not teaching na ask administrator okay other course details ask administrator only core java related ask me manish ask nag babu he will help you Rahil you have to come to Hyderabad for placement okay currently everything going online no need to come but in future if required to come to offline you have to come to Hyderabad Rahul already answered okay only core java course is 3 months this is a course schedule for the students who are completed their academics ready for the job people who join first year or second year people who are doing first year second year only core java you join don't join other courses okay clear which book is best for core java by Harikrishna is best DevOps course you will take later first you concentrate on core java first you learn programming bhaiya DevOps is a process na you want to go to DevOps directly go to DevOps that is completely different story I will cover data structure as part of collections I will give you the material bhaiya as part of our course I will give material you no need to buy any textbooks it's not college right I will give my own material suitable to software industry the textbooks are there in the market not suitable to software industry they are suitable to only passing your college exams okay No, Naresh ID campus interview only for freshers, not for experienced. Yogesh, only core Java. I will teach core Java 5 batches. Currently, new batch is 4 o'clock. 7 a.m. after 45 days. 9 a.m. after 2 months. Yeah, Tarkesh, if you want a job in Java, complete thing you have to learn. When will you get material? Once you complete payment, you will get material. Up to Java real-time project, it will take 7 to 8 months, or up to HTML, nor above. Complete course array, complete all courses, it takes 7 to 8 months because there is no space here. That's why written here gap, okay? Material soft copy, not hard copy. There is no 8 p.m. batch. Sir, learning core Java help to get job in electronics? No, it will not help. Only IT side. Core Java is not enough to get job. Up to advanced Java you should learn. Any other questions? Data warehousing side, you should already know Oracle now. Why you need to join Oracle again? Not required. Python also same thing, Baba. Core Java place Python will come. Advanced Java place Django will come. Oracle, HTML, okay, frameworks, REST API, Hibernate and Spring Boot place, you will get Django. Advanced Java, Hibernate, Spring place, you are getting Django. XML web services place, you will get REST API. Chenchu Babu, what is your question? Can you please reply? I mean, can you repeat once again the question? Are testing side only core Java, Selenium you have to learn. This is the fourth time or fifth time I'm answering. While I'm answering questions to other people, why don't you listen, Rabba? CRT means campus recruitment training aptitude. Ankit, if you go one after one, it takes 2 years to complete. I given a plan already. Again, you are asking one after one, parallel, and what I can do. CRT batch schedule, you go and refer Naresh IT website. For Python, we have 3 faculties. Satish Gupta sir, Srinivas sir, Subaraju sir. Based on their demo classes, you comfort, you can join. All are good. Yeah, after completion of every course, you will get course completion certificate. Core Java Advanced was sufficient for software developer to get job as a fresher, Chenchu Babu, not as an experienced. If you want to get experienced job, you have to learn frameworks also. Yeah, no need to do payment today. Tomorrow, day after tomorrow, you can do that. NASCOM certificate will come from full stack Java developer, not core Java developer. There is no 11 p.m. batch, 11 a.m. batch. Core Java fee 2500. Okay, course details. Core Java with project development with Java 11, Java SE 11, developer certification, and JVM architecture. Okay, target of this course is making you software engineer with a compiler and JVM knowledge. Course duration 3 months plus YouTube videos. Our course is starting date April 5th. April, May, June, July. Okay, so maximum will complete by August 5th. Okay, Next, fees is 2500 up to Java feature. Daily class will be 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Okay, duration 90 sessions. Yeah, 90 sessions minimum will take 1 hour 50 minutes per day. This is not a deadline, okay? Maximum we'll try to complete by that time. If it takes some more time also, we will try to take. If you need some more time also, I will take. I'm just keeping that one. Next, if you want to contact administrator, you have to follow this one. Sorry. Number, I need to change number. One minute. I need to change number. 9553377893. Okay, that's admin number you have to follow, and there is no recorded videos, everything is live class. Okay, that is the information. Still, if you have any questions, ask. Hope I answered all your questions. I'm not receiving your chat messages. Are you there? Something is happening here. Yeah. Yeah, soft copy material is downloadable. Already given phone number, bhai. Don't you see messages I'm sending? My number already given. Other than core Java technical things, please talk to administrator. Batch details, I don't know, right? I'm not administrator. Okay. I give an administrator number, contact him, send a WhatsApp message. Subject wise, any questions, ask me. Batches details, ask the administrator. He will help you. Okay. Okay, so thank you. So that's all for today class. We'll meet you tomorrow. Thank you, everyone. And if I don't answer any of your question, tomorrow I will answer, okay? So now I have another class. We'll answer to your question tomorrow. And if you have any subject-wise doubts, ask me. Technical course-wise doubts, you can ask to Nagbabu. He will help you, okay? Thank you. Only send WhatsApp message. Don't call. He will not lift your call. Thank you.